People ask me that question all the time. What's it like being a comedian? Well, it's got its pains and it's got its struggles, but at the same time, the reward is incredibly rich. I've met so many wonderful people, famous people, really famous people, but I can't tell you about them because they're famous and they'd kill me. Gosh, it's such a great life. Gosh, when I think of all the things I've done, places I've been to Morocco and Akron, it's amazing. Gosh, just love this life. Limousines everywhere, here, there, hanging out with the Beatles. It's been insane. Oh my gosh, I get to eat at the best restaurants with the crown heads of Europe. It's amazing. It has its ups and downs, but it's my art, and I love it, and I live for it. And this one time, we were at Courtney Love's house.
Excuse me?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Autograph.
No. We want you to take our order now. We've been waiting.
The truth is, I don't stand a chance. It's something that you're born into, and I just don't belong. No, I don't. I'm just a no-class beat-down fool, and I will always be that.
I think I need a better option. I was a comedian. I did wait tables, as all good comedians do. I got my degree in theater. I then went out into the world of, you know, performance, and with that usually comes a job waiting tables. I worked at a cafe, a couple of cafes for quite a while. You know, I had a very good time. I enjoyed it. I love comedy. At the root of that is I just love making people laugh. I love, giving that to people, seeing other people happy, enjoying themselves. That's the bottom line with that. But there came a point in it where I started to become a little bit dissatisfied with what I was doing. I took some time off from comedy just to consider what I was going to do. That notion of becoming a priest, becoming a Jesuit, kind of came into my head, and I pushed it away because I'm a comedian, you know, and comedians aren't supposed to do that kind of thing. That's not, you know, I wasn't particularly holy or anything like that, but it kept reoccurring. So I slowly investigated. I took very small steps. I met and had dinner with some seminarians, and that was a really fantastic experience. I went in with a very poor attitude, but these seminarians seemed so happy and content with their lives and what they were doing. And it really struck me because I wasn't expecting that at all. I was expecting something entirely different, and so I took another step, and then I met with the Jesuits, and I had dinner with them, and I felt immediately welcomed, so warm. I really felt like I was at home, and they loved the fact that I was a comedian, and so it didn't become this whole thing where I had to give up comedy and become a Jesuit. Like, you know, they told me that this was one of my gifts, and that this is something that God gave me, and that I could continue to use it, but use it in a more fulfilling and satisfying way. I never considered that before. I never thought of that. Like, oh my gosh, you know, I can do this, and I can do what I love to do, and it can become so much more than what it was, and it can, you know, I could use it to serve God, and I had never even considered that, and it was pretty remarkable. And so, and that's how it's worked out. I get to do comedy, and I get to enjoy my life, and yet at the same time be fulfilled with my life as it is, you know, and feel that I am doing something greater than just serving myself and pursuing all of these, you know, kind of self-serving, self-seeking goals. And it's been a really, really remarkable life.
Sense is a little whack.